Here with Hillary Clinton, who, of course, is also a former First Lady. And as I was discussing with Anita Brick-Rudd before, there is a First Lady's Club, if you will. And you got to know Nancy Reagan that way.
I did, starting when my husband was governor of Arkansas. And we would go every year to the White House for the annual governor's dinner. And that's how I met both President and Mrs. Reagan. And in the years following that, we had occasion as First Ladies, both present and former, to be involved in promoting good causes, to see one another on occasion. And, you know, I think that she had not only an incredible relationship with her husband and supported him in every way, but she had a lot of courage and grit. Her grace and strength after the attempt and assassination was extraordinary. And the work that she did in later years on Alzheimer's, standing up for research and pushing the agenda forward, is something that I deeply respect.
And in fact, she went against orthodoxy at the time and against the current president, Republican President George W. Bush. She really believed in that, and you've helped advance that farther.
I did. And it was very brave of her to take a political stand on behalf of research that she thought might help prevent or cure Alzheimer's. She had lived with the disease because of her husband's suffering from it. And I thought her voice really added to what President Reagan had done, because, you know, the dispute was over embryonic stem cell research. And when President Reagan was president, he had a panel of experts look at this, and they concluded that there was a role for that. And then, of course, it is, in the eyes of many, controversial, although it has played a role in all kinds of medical advances. And when Mrs. Reagan spoke out, that really added to the weight of the expert opinion and the voices of so many people suffering from diseases like Alzheimer's.
And also Parkinson's. Michael J. Fox was another partner of hers in
That's
those
right.
efforts. Certainly our friend Maria Shriver, whose father, Sarge Shriver, suffered from the disease. We talked to Chris Matthews about his mother, and that's how he got to know Nancy Reagan. They used to lunch and have dinner out here, but it was always on that around that issue.
That's right. And, you know, the last time I saw her, she was still, you know, very in her elegant, soft-spoken way, determined to promote the research that was needed. And I really was grateful for that. You know, obviously, everywhere I go around the country, I meet people talking to me about Alzheimer's and about what their experiences have been. And it's going to be a bigger and bigger challenge. And I think her contributions to this fight will be long remembered.
There's another issue on which you've been very outspoken, and I remember so vividly the assassination attempt and the suffering of Jim Brady, and the fact that she and Ronald Reagan went against their friends, Charlton Heston and others, and supported the Brady Bill.
That's right. And that was another very important stand that both President and Mrs. Reagan took. Look, we've got to do something. We have 33,000 people a year dying from gun violence. I know there's a way that we can reconcile constitutional rights with common sense, gun safety measures. And the fact that both she and President Reagan were clear about that. And when something happens to you, like a good dear friend, Jim Brady, being, you know, shot and suffering, your husband having Alzheimer's, it can't help but change your perspective. And I wish more people would pay attention to those who've gone through these issues. The other point I wanted to make, too, is it may be hard for your viewers to remember how difficult it was for people to talk about HIV/AIDS back in the 1980s. And because of both President and Mrs. Reagan, in particular Mrs. Reagan, we started a national conversation when before nobody would talk about it, nobody wanted to do anything about it. And, you know, that too is something that I really appreciate with her very effective, low-key advocacy, but it penetrated the public conscience and people began to say, hey, we have to do something about this too.
Did the fact that she was behind the scenes, at least, so involved on the policy side, quietly but effectively, make it easier for people like yourself when you came into the White House to be more active as things evolved.
I don't think there's any question that that's true. You know, this role is really, you know, so unique. Everyone brings to it, up until now, her perspective, her experiences, and I admire all of my predecessors because there's no, you know, there's no formula, there's no guidebook you're given. You have to figure out how to support your husband and his agenda, his presidency, but also find a role for yourself. And, you know, she did that on the anti-drug front when she spoke out about the danger of drugs. And she also did it behind the scenes on policy. A lot of people point out her role in encouraging the president to work with Gorbachev, to be willing to, you know, test this new leader out, made a big difference. And there were other examples of that as well. And it is an important opportunity, and she took advantage of it.
Well, we have to let you get inside and pay tribute in your own personal way. But thank you very much, and perhaps she has laid the ground for other spouses to come.
I hope
male
so.
Male and female.
Well, she deserves to be remembered for her many contributions.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anne.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.